My name's Natalie Byrne. I'm an illustrator and an author. I make work around social issues, and I completely blank what I was going to say. Can I have the next slide, please? So this is my journey. I started as a graphic designer, and right when kind of Trump and Brexit started to happen, I had a lot of thoughts and feelings about everything that I started sharing and posting on my social media. And I did that for a few years, and I started getting work as an illustrator. And yeah, it's been a very slow journey, but I'm here. And I just kind of make work that matters to me. I try to make work that I feel like people aren't, about conversations that people aren't having. And my first book, period, which is on the next slide, hopefully, I came about when I went to the period protest, a few of them, and someone got up on the podium and said, there's no books about periods. And I thought, maybe that's not true. And I went into my library and, yeah, it was true. There wasn't that many books about periods. So I thought, well, I kind of talked about it in the pub and complained, like, there should probably be some books about periods. Why has no one made that yet? And after a few months of complaining, I realized I am someone who makes things. Maybe I can try and make it. It was just such an incredible experience. I made it when I was still working as a graphic designer. I think it came out when I was full-time as an illustrator for like 3 months. So it was very early on in my career, but it's one of my most proudest projects that I've been a part of. And I don't just talk about periods, I talk about mental health and hormones and sustainable options, and ended up being like a really thick book. But it's everything you need to know about periods, period. And yeah, that book is available on my website if anyone is interested, nataliebyrne.uk. But my second book, which is on the table on the over there, which is on the next slide, hopefully, yes, Break the Mold, written by Sinead Burke, who's an incredible activist. And it's a children's book aimed to kind of be a manual to allow people to be themselves and realize that things that set them apart are their best attributes. And it's a wonderful book that I illustrated, and yeah, it's just such a beautiful book. Please buy it if you'd like to. And yeah, next slide, please. So today we're gonna talk about, well, we're gonna make a zine, and a zine is a self-published piece of work, and they are incredible ways of kind of making things really quickly because you don't need any gatekeepers, you don't need anyone's permission. And I made a zine about my breakup after 6 years. I realized that I love using art to help heal my own pain. So I made my first zine about my breakup, and it's still like the most thing that people talk to me about is this. And it's lovely because it's so nice to make something beautiful out of something that can be quite difficult to go through. And so I hope that you'll all enjoy making something. And I think there is another slide. So zines, I don't know if you've heard the phrase before, but they originally, because you don't need any gatekeepers to make a zine, lots of people made them before they got popular in the punk movement. In Riot Girl, also used a lot of zines to share their ideas about feminism or just make a zine that they liked about a band. And I love them because, yeah, you don't need anyone's permission to make a zine. And I think that's... okay, so this is the folding of the... that's on the worksheet. If anyone has any difficulties, you can put your hand up and I'll come and help you. But thanks so much for listening to me talk, and I'm going to help you along with making all your lovely zines now.
1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2. It feels like.